गुड आफ्टरनून क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज डेटाबेस. ओके, बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद डेटाबेस आई वांट टू मेक सम क्विक रिवीजन ऑन व्हाट यू हैव लर्नड अबाउट डेटाबेस इन योर प्रीवियस कॉन्सेप्ट्स. सी द सॉफ्टवेयर, any software you take has two ends. One is called front end, another one is called back end. Front end is something which you give to the end user. Suppose now you are a software developer, so you will design a software and you will give the front end software to the user, your customer. He'll be using that. He's not aware about what is going on at the back end. What is back end? The other end of the software is back end. What is back end? Back end is nothing but the database where actually the data gets saved. Okay, so what is this database all about? See, database is nothing but it is a software which is used for storing and retrieving the data while considering appropriate security measures, and the data is been filtered the way you want, the way you want to sort. Now just imagine if you go in bank, the banks must be having such a huge database. Suppose you go in ATM, now you are the end user of SBI bank, you are the user. So when you go in ATM doesn't shows you the list of all the customers of SBI bank with all their bank details. What is displayed on your ATM is just a designing form where it asks only for your PIN code, the amount which you want to withdraw. The moment you do proper selection, you get the money in your hand. That's it. But at the back end, what happens is from your account number, that much of amount is deducted. So where this all process goes on, it goes on in the database. So these banks are having their big databases. Now what is this database? As I have told you, it is storing and retrieving of users' data. Now what is data? Data is a unit or just a collection of facts and figures. Okay, and when this data becomes meaningful, now suppose I have name and address of all the people of KED, but if I filter out, if I say I want only the data about the students of Rotary, that means out of those facts and figures I have just filtered some meaningful data. So that meaningful data is nothing but information. Okay, so in database the data is stored, and every time what you do is you filter out, you sort out the data. So that is known as information. Now we are talking about data, information, okay, database. So how this data is saved in these databases? It is saved in a form of tables. It is saved in a tabular format, in a form of rows and columns. So now we will see what is table, rows, columns, okay, what is degree, cardinality. What is table? Table is a set of tabular representation of data in form of rows and columns. Okay, what is a row? Row is nothing but the single tulip, you can say, okay, or you can call it as tuple, which is holding information about particular individual. What is column? Column is also called as attribute, which holds similar type of data. Okay, row is horizontal and column is vertical. What is degree? Degree means, suppose if the question comes, what is degree of this table? So degree is nothing but number of columns in that table. What is cardinality? Cardinality is nothing but number of rows in the table. Okay, now we are talking about database, table, rows, columns, cardinality, degree. Now we need to know what is RDBMS. DBMS is clear, which is having multiple tables. Now if you want to set relationship in between the tables, what you need to do is you need to know what is RDBMS. So what is RDBMS? It is nothing but relational database management system. Now see, I have ATM of SBI, but debit card of SBI, but nearby I am not getting the ATM of SBI. So what I'll do, I'll go to IDBI or ICICI ATM and I'll withdraw the money. Now see, these two are different banks, but still IDBI, ICICI banks allows me to withdraw the money from their bank account. Why? Because SBI, IDBI, ICICI, these all banks have become centralized bank. They all have shared their data bases. So just imagine I have a debit card from Khed branch, but right now I am in Nainital or I am in Srinagar and I am in need of money. I can still withdraw money from there irrespective of location, because all the branches, all different centralized banks have come together and share their databases. So the sharing of this databases, that means forming relationship between this databases, is called as RDBMS. Okay, now we have till now seen about the terminologies like RDBMS, DBMS. What is key? Here key is nothing but the set of rules which are been sent on the columns. For example, primary key. What is primary key? Primary key is uniquely identifying column in a table. For example, your roll number in your class table will be, your roll number will be unique. No two students can have same roll number. Okay, your Aadhaar card number, no two students will never share the same Aadhaar card number, same PAN card number. Okay, so that is called as primary key. What is foreign key? Foreign key is nothing but a primary key of one table referred or used in another table is called as primary foreign key. Okay, suppose your GR number is a primary key in admission table, and the same GR number, your general register number, is used suppose in your library table, then there it will be referred as foreign key. What is candidate key? Candidate key is a minimal set of columns which are combined together and which uniquely identifies the record. Okay, so that is called candidate key. Suppose your student ID, student name. So these two columns are combined together and it forms a candidate key. What is alternate key? Alternate key means if one table is having more than one uniquely identifying column. For example, your basic info table. In that table, suppose you are having Aadhaar card, PAN card, passport number, okay, your GR number. So these all are there. Now this all four, five columns all are uniquely identifying. So you can set any one of it as primary key and rest others will be your alternate keys. Okay. What is composite key? Composite key means combination of two or more columns forming a single primary key. Okay. Don columns ekatra karun form zareli key is called as composite key. Okay. So see here the pictures. Primary key of one table, student ID, is used in another table, department, where this student ID becomes foreign key. Okay, candidate key, student ID and last name, when combined together, first name, last name, they are combined, and student ID, they all combination forms a candidate key. What is alternate key? Multiple uniquely identifying columns forms alternate key. Okay, what is composite key? Customer ID, product code, this all becomes composite key. Okay, now we will just see that as there are multiple tables in a database, how they are being accessed. See, there is projection operation, where projection of a relation here means table, is defined as projection of all its tuples over same set of attributes, means just displaying the data the way it is called projection. If you are combining two different tables, then it is called union operation. Okay, in union, see 1 2 3 union 2 3 4, so it will be 1 2 3 4. Okay, intersection operation, where only the common factors will get described among the two tables. If you intersect two different tables, so what is common in two different tables, only that much part will get displayed. Difference is opposite. What is not common, what is uncommon will be displayed in difference operation. Cartesian product means multiplication of two tables, permutation combination of two tables. Suppose one table having three records, another table having four records, so total it will display me 3 into 4 12 records. Okay, what is join operation? Joining means combining two tables. Okay, so it can be cross join. Okay, now actually this all were just terminologies. Now actually we will have, in the next lecture we will have a quick review on the queries. Okay, SQL and its queries. See, to deal with database you need to know the language. So that language which you will be learning is structured query language. Okay, SQL. This SQL is having two basic categories, that is data definition and data manipulation. So by using SQL you will be learning what is DDL, what is DML. That is going to get covered in your next lecture. Okay, so okay students, have a good day, take care. We have just started with the second half of your syllabus, SQL, which is very interesting. What you need to do is try to install SQL setup at your home if you have laptop or desktop. If you don't have, don't worry. In your school, whenever you will come back, at that time you will get the practice sessions over here. Okay? Listen the video carefully. If you have any doubt, put your doubts on WhatsApp. Okay, bye.